We're going to have to look at the amount of radioactivity that was released and try and follow the direction of the plume where the radioactivity was released and do as many measurements on the ground of how much radioactivity was released in the ground, do as many measurements as possible of how much radioactivity there is in the air, and then do an indirect calculation then of how much radiation exposure any individual in any particular location would get.